Greetings to all, welcome back. We will revise the lesson 1. Okay, now say 2 mark question answers, question number 3. Okay, 2 mark question answers, question number 3. I hope you studied remaining question answers which one I taught for you. Okay, the question is, list out the features of a megalithic burial type. Okay, list out the features of a megalithic burial type. So the answer is under the heading megalithic burial types. Okay, megalithic burial types. The Iron Age is also known as the megalithic. That's all I explained in the last class. Okay, megalithic. What's the reason? Because in that megalithic period, the people used iron, and with the help of that iron, they prepared different implements. Okay, so that megalithic age is also known as what? Iron Age. Iron Age is also known as megalithic. Since people create burials with large stones, in this megalithic period only, for the burials, understand, people used very big stones. This is also one of the reasons, okay? This megalithic age is called as what? Iron Age. And within these burials, so the dead body is there, with that dead body, skeletons. And see, the people, those who excavated, this archaeologist, they found out, with the help of that only, we can get these ideas, okay? So these burials, skeletons are there. In some of these burial grounds, only the full body skeleton is there. In some of these burial areas, we can see, means only few bones. Only few bones, okay, of the dead persons. Sometimes we can see grave goods also in the burials. Grave goods, understand, grave goods in Tamil means what? The people, those who died, which and all things they used, that else they were placing or keeping inside that. Okay, like that what and all iron objects, okay, that megalithic age is called as iron age, no? So iron object they were keeping, cornelian beads in Tamil also, cornelian muthukal, it is there, cornelian muthukal, the same meaning only, and bronze objects in Galapagos. Okay, so some of the burials do not have human bones. And when we are seeing, when they are excavating, the archaeologists, when they are excavating, they are seeing that no more dead body was there inside. No more dead body was there. Only what is there? This grave goods. Grave goods are there. So they are thinking that they are called memorial burials. They are called what? Memorial burials. Okay, one more time. Megalithic burial types. Okay, megalithic burial types. The Iron Age, that is known as what? This is a megalithic. What is the reason? In those days or in that age, the people used iron for preparing implements. So that is known as what? Iron Age, megalithic. One more reason we can say, okay? And a lot of stones for the dead people, when the dead people is buried, they are using what? For the burials, they are keeping large stones. Within these burials, what and all we can see? Sometimes some of the burial grounds, we can see only skeletons. In some other burials, only few bones. Okay, bones. And the dead bones of these dead persons. And inside that burial area, so what is there? This grave goods they were keeping. Iron objects. Okay, iron objects. Next, cornelian beads, cornelian, manikal, muttukal, we can say. And next one, we can say bronze objects. The objects or the things made of bronze. It is known as what? Bronze objects. And some of the burials do not have human bones. Even a small bone is also not there. Okay, no more bones. And they have only grave goods. Only what? Grave goods. And they may be called memorial burials. Without bones or without a skeleton, understand, something is there and the only grave goods are there. Okay, something means what? Only grave goods are there. So they may be called as what? Memorial burials. Okay, this much is about what? Megalithic burial type. Next question number 4. Okay, examine the tool making technical skills in the lower Paleolithic people. Lower Paleolithic people, what are the tools they made and what's the name for that? How the people used that one. That is the meaning of the question. Okay. That is the meaning of the question. Okay. The answer is under the heading Yes, it is Lower Paleolithic culture. Lower Paleolithic culture. Under that we can see the answer for this question. Okay. First one we can see. See the people, various tools, they made various tools. Okay, different kinds, different sets, different varieties of tools were made by this Lower Paleolithic people. First one we can see hand axes. Understand? Good. Hand axes. With the help of hand they were using. Hand axe means godari. Hand axe. Kai godari we can say. Second one is cleavers. Cleavers are nowadays also we are using for each and every purpose. Anything we want to cut means we are using cleavers. That is vettukuthi. Am I correct? Cleavers. So first one what? Hand axes. Second one is what? Cleavers. To meet their subsistence needs, they used hand axes plus cleavers. What's the use of that? To meet their subsistence needs. What's the meaning of subsistence needs? Valkeki devi. Very, very important nowadays, that is. And these tools are known as bifaces. Bifaces, see this meaning B-I, B-I-F-A-C-E. Bi means two. Understand? Bi means B-I, bi means two. B-Y not, B-Y, that's a preposition. Okay. So here, B-I, bi means what? Two. Faces means sides. So bifaces means what? Two sides. Example, very easily we can understand. What is it? Knife. Okay, knife. Cleaver. Axe, all these are the best examples for what? Biface tools. Okay, biface tools. And the hand axe tools are also known as Acheulean. Okay, hand axe tools are also known as what? Acheulean. Why is this name Acheulean? Why it is called as Acheulean tools? Actually, Acheul, Saint Acheul is a place that is in France. Understand? Saint Acheul, that is in France. Okay, France. So these hand axes are first of all found in Acheul in France only. Okay, first of all found in Acheul in France. So these tools are called as what? Acheulean tools. Okay, Acheulean tools. So the hand axe tools of this Lower Paleolithic people is called as what? Acheulean tools, because Saint Acheul, that is a place or that is a region or that's area in where France, okay, in that Saint Acheul only they found this hand axes first. Okay, so it is called as what? What is this called as what? Acheulean tools. And this tool making tradition, it was continued up to 250,000 years. Okay, 250,000 years to 60,000 years. 250,000 years to 60,000 years ago in our country India. In our country India. So this one here, Lower Paleolithic people, they made various tools. What are the tools? Hand axe, cleavers. They were giving much importance for the production of these two. Understand these two. And these tools are known as bifaces, two sides. Bi, B-I, bi, that is two. Face means sides, two sides. Example I said, nowadays also we are using knife, axe, cleavers, example for that. And these hand axe tools are also known as Acheulean, because Saint Acheul is a place in France. There only these tools are first they found, so Acheulean tools. Higher India, how, what see they, how it was continued? See, tool make tradition continued up till 250,000 to 60,000 years ago in India. Understand? So these are the four question answers. Last class we studied many things, and here also two question answers. Next we will see the paragraph question answers. Question number one. Okay, question number one. The development in the field of agriculture, pottery, metal tools are considered a landmark in the life of Megalithic period. Okay, substantiate. The last word is substantiate. Urudipaduthal. Okay, see the question. Development in the field of agriculture, that is in the Megalithic period. Megalithic period means what? Iron age. The people used iron to produce iron implements. So Megalithic. In that Megalithic period, agriculture developed. Okay, you know agriculture is the backbone of Indian economy. Okay, that the people gave much importance to agriculture for getting food. Okay, so the agriculture, pottery, pot, they made pot also, and the metal tools. okay, with the help of metals they made different kinds of tools, and it is a very important change came because of the development of agriculture, pottery and metal tools in the Megalithic period. How can we say it changed? It developed because of agriculture, because of pottery making, and because of metal tool. That only we are going to learn. Okay. The answer is in how to see the heading? Agriculture and pastoralism. The same question came for 2 mark question also. Anyhow, one more time I'm going to explain that one. The people of Iron Age practiced agriculture. They practiced agriculture, you know, domesticated cattle and sheep also. And some groups of the people, their main work was hunting as well as gathering. They were giving much importance for the production of rice as well as millets also. Irrigation management developed, and since megalithic sites found near tanks, rivers and tanks. Okay, this sentence how to include, because this is a big answer. Okay, for a small question, this point don't want. This sentence don't want. Here see that one. In this period, since many of the megalithic sites are found nearby rivers and tanks. Why the people are living or settling nearby the rivers as well as the tanks? What's the reason? Why they are settling in that areas? Because they gave much importance for the agriculture, for the production of different food items. That is the reason. Okay. In the deltoic region, you know, artificial irrigation was developed, irrigation technology developed, and evidence of rice on two areas. First one, what? Adichanallur in Thoothukudi, that is, and next one, Porunthal near Palani. Adichanallur in Thoothukudi and Porunthal in Palani. And the next heading, pottery. This is also the answer for the first paragraph question. Okay, first paragraph question. Pottery is an important evidence. Pottery is an important evidence. The people give much importance for the production of pots. Not like nowadays. Nowadays, we are not at all using the vessels made by which one is clay, that is pot. Okay. So, pottery and evidence found in archaeological sites. How can we understand that one? The people used pottery or people used pots with the help of archaeology. You know what is archaeology? Study of the human past. The people, those who are studying about the human past, is known as what? Archaeologists. Okay. You should know the difference between these two. Now, the Iron Age and Sangam Age people used black and red colors. Iron Age people, that is megalithic people, okay, and the people Sangam Age people, okay, Sangam Age people, they also used two colors, red color as well as black color, to make the pots. Potteries were used for cooking. Now we will see what are the uses of these pots. What are the uses for cooking? Nowadays we are not at all using the pots for cooking except one or two houses. Okay. Next one, storage. Want to keep something. Want to store something. For that also they were using that pots only. And the third one is dining purposes. For dining, for eating. For eating. Nowadays, children, you should know, we are not at all using any kinds of pots for dining. Okay, like that it is. So, what are the uses of pots? Here, what? Cooking, storage, and also dining. Cooking, storage, and also dining purposes. The black and red color wear pottery is black inside and red outside. I said already, they used two colors, black and red. Whenever they are preparing these pots, the black and red pear pot, black color is inside the pot, red color is outside. Okay, black color is inside black color and outside red color. With lustrous surfaces, lustrous, what's the meaning of lustrous? Doesn't lustrous. Surface means what? Outside. Okay, so using black color and red color, and black color is inside and red color is outside. And here we can see the lustrous palavalapana surface outside we can see. So one more time, pottery making. Pottery is an important evidence. Pottery is an important evidence found in the archaeological sites. That means with the help of archaeology, only we can get a clear-cut idea about this pot making. Okay, and the Iron Age people and the Sangam Age people, they used black and red color pots. And we can say one more time, another way, black color they used, red color they used for making pots. And what are the uses of pots now? What are the uses of for cooking, for storing and for dining? Only three: cooking, storing and for dining. Okay, next one, the black, they used black and red color now when they were making the pots. Black color is inside, outside we can see means red color. Okay, with the lustrous palabalapan surface outside velipura. The last one is the last heading or last point of this first question is iron technology and metal tools. Iron technology and metal tools. First one, they used different varieties of weapons that you know, understand. First one is sword, wall we can say, and dagger means kuru wall, chinna wall, kuru wall. Okay, and axes, Kodari, and chisel, only they used, and lamps, vilakugal, you know, and tripod stands. See, nowadays we cannot see in the, then if we have grandfather and grandmother's their houses, it is the tripod stands, mukkali we can say, only three legs. So that is known as what tripod stands are also found now. The iron tools were used for agriculture. What are the uses of these iron tools? What are the uses of that iron tools for agriculture, hunting, gathering, collecting foods, and in battles? From this we can understand that the people fought against each other. So what are the uses? They are using this for these tools for agriculture. This next one, what? Hunting, gathering, and in battles also. Next, bronze bowls made of bronze bowls, vessels with stylish finials decorated with animals and birds. One vessel is there, decorated very nicely with the picture of animals as well as birds. Very beautiful to see, understand? That also they used. So first one, what? Bronze bowls and vessels stylish, beautifully decorated with the help of birds as well as animals pictures, and bronze mirrors. Nowadays we cannot see bronze, they were using bronze mirrors. See this outer cover, it is made of what? Bronze, like that they used. And bells have also been found, bells, you know, man. So all these things they used. Okay, weapons, what and all? Swords, daggers, axes, chisels, lamps, tripod stands. Okay, that also they used. Now, iron, what are the uses of these iron tools? For what and all they used these iron tools? For agriculture, hunting, gathering, and also battles. Okay, and bronze bowls they used. Okay, bronze, the bowls with the help of bronze they made. And next one, what? Vessels, style is finials, that is one vessel is there means decorated with different varieties, kinds of birds as well as animals. Very beautiful to see, am I correct? Next one, and bells have also been found. Okay, so we learned two short answers and paragraph question one. People, you learn very nicely. But thus, I finish today's session and I'll meet you in the next session with another question answers and some important points. Okay, children, thank you.